help, the most merciful, the most beneficial. His Excellency, President Abdurrahman Siwar Dahab, the former President of Sudan, Sheikh Khalid bin Thani Al Thani, Lord and Lady Sheikh, members of the Palace of Westminster, ambassadors, representatives of charitable organizations, the business community, ladies and gentlemen. I am delighted as the chairman on the occasion of our 25th year to welcome you here tonight on behalf of the Board of Trustees, the staff, and the volunteers of Al-Muntada Islamic Trust. Since our formation in 1986, we have always stood by the poor and disadvantaged, serving as an institution that respects all. Our message was, and still is, compassion, tolerance, and moderation, and to ensure that peace prevails on our planet. It comes as no surprise that the humanitarian and developmental world in the Islamic world faces crises and challenges. It is our belief that the best way to overcome this is by showing respect, cooperation, and setting a good example. Allow me, dear audience, to take you on a short review of our history. In 1986, the trust was established by a group of 7 students and academics to provide a support network for the local community in Parsons Green in London. In the early years, the focus was on the maintenance of community center and good governance. In 1989, saw the opening of the primary school, and the focus was on providing valued services to the local West London community. At the beginning of the 90s, work started towards international charity in a number of different regions of the world. In 1995, this became focused onto sub-Saharan Africa, where we now specialize. Work started on a number of educational projects in Ghana, Mali, Nigeria, Ethiopia, Djibouti, Kenya, Uganda, and Chad. There was also a response toward natural disaster, emergency, and drought in Sudan. In Sudan, for example, a major project was implemented to address water shortage in the east, where more than 700 wells and 19 water stations were built. Eye clinics were set up using medical volunteers every year to triage the cases of blindness in Chad, Nigeria, Mali, Djibouti, Somalia, Senegal, Benin, and Togo. In 1999, we started a project to build up the capacity of African leadership through the establishment of management training courses, workshop, panel discussion, and direct reading. More than 800 people a year from 20 countries have benefited from this program. In 2003, we established a plan to transfer all our sub-offices to local African ownership. This helped them to achieve self-sufficiency as charities in their own right, and able to work in partnership with the trust or with other organizations should they wish. The number of established partners we have now has reached 26 in 17 countries. Over the last decade, we have offered university scholarship to 500 students a year from across 20 African countries. Some of the beneficiaries of this program have even reached PhD level after they completed degrees in subjects such as education, law, management, information technology, and international development, all subjects needed by communities to meet the challenges of African development. We have also entered into partnership with the Islamic Development Bank in the operation and management of three educational institutes in Somalia. In 2008, we entered into a partnership with the organization of ISISCO to develop more education projects. We have recently began supporting partners. We have recently began supporting partner agencies with the development of new curricula for schools. This year, we have initiated a large project to develop the leadership capacity of 100 African charities over the next 4 years to help improve their administrative efficiency, structure, and effectiveness. In our 25th year, we are launching tonight a health project in response to the objectives of the United Nations Millennium Development Goal to combat malaria and improve the health of mothers in partnership with a number of international organizations and African governments. We were keen to carefully examine the reality on the ground first. So we completed a survey during our visit to West Africa at the beginning of this year with the cooperation of ministries of health, hospitals, and medical colleagues. In the first 3 years, the project will focus on 5 countries, namely Mali, Benin, Togo, Ghana, and Nigeria, before expanding further. I extend an invitation to everyone here tonight to participate in this humanitarian project with us. Here in London, we continue to provide our educational services in the primary and the secondary school for girls that we established in 2005. And this year, our school won high praise by the office inspectors. In the provision of services for young people, we have focused on communication with the sports clubs around us, such as Chelsea, QPR, and Fulham football clubs. And we have found everyone to be most welcoming and keen to cooperate. We have also established an Muntada Club for youth, and we are on the way to enter into partnership with similar institutions such as Mosaic and others. We We have recently entered into a joint venture with the Chelsea Club Foundation. This is just a short review of our recent history. Over the years, we recognize that these achievements often go unreported by the media. Often Al-Muntada is only known about by those most closely associated with it. So, an important part of our new strategy will be to convince the media of the value of our work. Tonight, I extend an invitation to all the journalists here to be partners in our future success. I would like to thank all of our current partners in Britain and Africa, the government agencies and international organizations for their work with us and for their continued support. I should like to thank you for coming here tonight. It is my hope that you will take an interest in Al-Muntada and be ambassadors for us. Finally, special thanks must go to the creators of our success over the past 25 years, to the founders and employees of the Trust. These volunteers and staff are the true builders of this glory. I ask God to have mercy on those who have died and to help us all to what He loves and accepts. Thank you and enjoy this evening. Thank you very much.